Welcome to your October newscast by CATSTV. I'm Amanda Dodd.
And I'm Allie Page. Get ready for all of the upcoming dates and events for the month of October.
Congrats to the senior class for winning the homecoming float contest with their Stranger Things float. It was amazing when their truck came driving by. They were also the most spirited group.
Also, CMS was very well represented with the cheerleaders, band attendants, and football team. Everything looked great and our school spirit was contagious. The winners of the pennant contest were Kennedy Phillips, Charlotte Mewks, and Brett Morrison. Reporter Madeline McCutcheon with the winning artist, Madeline.
CATSTV, and I'm here with one of the pennant contest winners, Brett. What was your inspiration for your pennant?
One of the Wildcat logos on the website.
Do you enjoy drawing?
Not at all.
Yes?
No, I'm joking, yeah.
And what kind of ice cream do you want for your prize?
Chocolate chip
ice cream.
Back to you at the desk.
Hi, I'm Madeline, and I'm here with Kennedy Phillips, the pennant contest winner. Did you have any inspiration for
it? I watch Stranger Things all the time, so I thought that would be a good idea to use the Stranger Things logo.
Do you enjoy drawing?
Sometimes.
And what kind of ice cream are you going to get for your prize?
Oreo.
That's a good choice. Back to you at the desk.
Hold up your pennant.
Hi, I'm Madeline with CATSTV, and I'm here with Shayla, our 7th grade pendant winner. What was your inspiration for your pendant design?
My inspiration was the Netflix show Friday Night Lights.
Do you enjoy drawing?
Yeah.
And what flavor ice cream are you going to get for your prize?
M&M.
Back to you at the desk.
There are only a few more home games for our junior high teams. The 19th is Eufaula and the 25th is against Bayan. Get ready to support our Cats against their opponents.
For the Eufaula game, we are having a football pep rally, so everyone should get ready to battle it out for the Spirit Sea. This is gonna be epic.
A big congrats to our Lady Cats softball team for finishing their season strong. The record doesn't matter. It's growing in the game that counts. Good job, Lady Cats.
My favorite part of October is obviously Halloween. Here's reporter Chloe Turney with some of our students' favorite things about Halloween. Now I believe in miracles and a
miracle is happening tonight. Hi, I'm Chloe Turney at Cats News. I'm here with Keegan, Angie, and Tara. What costumes are you guys looking forward to seeing this year?
Can you see somebody next to this Freddy Krueger?
Freddy Krueger? What's your favorite costumes you guys have ever seen?
They're inflatable dinosaurs.
I'm with Keegan on the inflatable dinosaurs thing. Mm-hmm. And that will be all.
This is Chloe Turning with CATSTV News here interviewing three of our own 7th graders, Shayla Waters, Jacqueline Fishman, and Mason Rainbow. So, what do you guys show us this year?
Ghost.
Ghost. The Purge.
I'm not dressing up, I'm going hunting.
What's the best costume you've ever seen?
A Karen. A peanut butter jelly sandwich.
I'll put a dinosaur.
What costume are you looking forward to seeing this year the most?
Just scary costumes.
Squid Game.
Yeah, what she said.
I hit this.
Thanks, Chloe and friends. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, October 13th, 14th, and 15th will be fall break, so please don't come to school. No one will be here. Enjoy some much-needed R&R. That is after a long night of parent-teacher conferences on Tuesday, October 12th, from 4 to 7. Here's your heads up. Get your grades up now before our parents show up. Another crazy new thing going on here at CMS is the accelerated reader. The 21st is the deadline, so get reading and do it fast. Remember that the win with the most points gets a pizza party with Coach Harris. Now get your brains ready, because we are ready to talk about the last week of October, which is going to be jam-packed full of craziness. First, October 25th through 29th is Red Ribbon Week, where CMS will step up to fight against drugs, alcohol, and destructive decisions. Remember, Red Ribbon Week will have dress-up days, with prizes for each day's best dress for each grade, along with an overall best dress at the end of the week. Here's a look at the week's dress-up days. Prizes each day given just for wearing your Red Ribbon Week bracelet. Teachers are entered too. Nevaeh Thomason was able to speak with Miss Roberts, who is in charge of Red Ribbon Week. Nevaeh?
Ho!
Hi, I'm Nevaeh. I'm interviewing Miss Roberts about Red Ribbon Week. Why do we even celebrate Red Ribbon Week?
Red Ribbon Week is to honor a man named Enrico Camarena, who went undercover with the drug cartel and was murdered. And so after that, we begin to realize that the fight against drugs here in America, we were losing the battle. So they decided to make younger kids aware that are in younger grades.
What is your favorite part of Red Ribbon Week?
I think giving the prizes to the most spirited, best dressed student, because they get real excited when they get a gift. We also do drawings with the Red Ribbon bracelet. So I think it's all a lot of fun for the kids, as well as learning about the negative parts of drugs.
What is your favorite Red Ribbon Week dress up day?
Well, this year, I'd have to say this year, probably Nerd Day, because that's really hilarious to watch all the kids. And then probably Halloween Day to scare away drugs.
What are you wearing on Halloween Day?
I don't know. I was thinking about being a witch. I think I could be a good witch.
Back to you at the desk.
Next day, Thursday, October 28th, will be the all-school Halloween dance at the old gym. The cost is $5, so we hope to see you there in costumes. Here's Ms. Fonberg with the deets.
Okay, so guys, I want all your classes to get ready to do a spirit yell. Next Tuesday, we will be having the Eufaula Shakota Pep Assembly, and each class will present a class yell, a chant, whatever you want to do. There will be a spirit C awarded to the class with the most spirit. So we want everybody to be able to be really spirited that day. We also have a fun surprise from the cheerleaders. So everybody come with your blue and white on and ready to go. Also, we are having a Halloween dance. So you guys wear your best costumes. That is also Red Ribbon Week. So we will be dressed up as Halloween that day, so you can wear that costume to the dance, or you can get another costume for the dance. The cost is $5, and we will be selling drinks for $1. So everybody come to our Halloween dance, and it will be a great time with lots of spooky people there.
Finally, that is it for the month of October. Here's a recap for all those dates and events.
The October staff highlight is Mrs. Burnett. Mrs. Burnett went to NSU and she says you should go there because it's close to home, a beautiful campus, and the instructors are helpful. About math, she says it always just came easy to her, so that's why she likes it. And if she weren't a teacher, she said, hopefully I would win the lottery. The October vocabulary word of the month is compassion. Compassion means pity or concern for the sufferings of others. The October slang word of the month is sheesh. Sheesh was made popular on TikTok. It signifies everything from bragging to cringe to excitement.
That's all for us here at the desk. Enjoy the month of October and go Cats!
Boo!